An urgent health alert tonight. The CDC warning doctors about the first cases of malaria caught in the U.S. in 20 years. Here to answer your questions is Dr. Todd Ellerin, Chief of Infectious Diseases at South Shore Health. Always good to see you, Dr. Ellerin.
Hey, Dr. T. It's great to see you. Just to say the word malaria, it gets your attention. So, as you know, malaria is one of the most serious public health threats in the world. In 2020, the mosquito-borne disease killed more than 627,000 people, nearly all in the continent of Africa. Well, now the CDC says it's confirmed that four cases in the state of Florida and one case in Texas from mosquitoes that are local to those areas. Still, that may be a small number, Dr. T, but why is the CDC so concerned?
As you said, we haven't seen what we call these local cases of malaria in 20 years. And so while we do see about 2,000 cases a year in the United States, that's from travel-associated malaria. So why it's important is because we want to make sure that there's not a change and where, you know, one of these parasites could have a foothold in the U.S. So it's important that the CDC and other departments of public health make sure that we're doing aggressive surveillance so we can detect this early, get the word out so we know what the symptoms are. Remember, malaria, we're not that familiar with. With that said, I've seen about a dozen cases, but that's over 20 years experience. So this isn't something we see every day.
Right,
so
right.
Dr. T, though, it's just important to remind everyone that when we use the word local, we don't mean it's down the street here in Newton. We're talking about it's in the United States. That's the use of the term local, right?
You're right, although what's important is that the mosquito, that Anopheles mosquito, is in Massachusetts. It's in New England. In fact, it's around the country as well. But the good news is there's different types of malaria. The most deadly form of malaria requires temperatures to be above 65 degrees in order for it to complete its life cycle in the mosquito. That's one of the reasons. Also, Massachusetts specifically has a very aggressive mosquito control program, surveillance. We have early detection. Yep. So those are reasons that we don't see this more commonly in the U.S. By the way, in 1850, malaria caused 5% of deaths in the United States. So we can't rest on our laurels. Mm-hmm. We have to be aggressive,
right.
And continue to surveil and detect.
Yeah, it makes complete sense here. The CDC, we know, says all five cases in the South are, quote, improving after treatment. So in your experience, do patients typically make a full recovery if they get malaria?
Without question. I talked about 2,000 cases in the United States each year. The overwhelming majority of those patients do well. There's only usually a handful of deaths every year. But remember, as Paul Farmer said, he has to make the problems of the poor compelling. Why did he say that? Because you just heard that over 600,000 deaths a year occur. Almost all of that is in Africa, and almost all of that is in children under five. This is a disease of the poor, people that don't have access to care. We know that we have the right therapeutics in the United States. We have excellent antibiotics to cure. We have the right diagnostics. But unfortunately, that's not true in other parts of the world. We have to narrow that gap.
Okay. All right, Dr. Ellerin, thank you so much for giving us your insight on this.
Great to see you, Dr. T. Take care. We're going to take you back.